you by my side. Top down and the moon is high and the mood is right. And you by my side, yeah. Late night conversations, electric emotions, sprinkled with a little bit of sex, and it's a potion, yeah. Late night bodies aching,
get a bit of news from Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app on your smart speaker in on 88 to 91 FM.
We're the BBC News at 6 o'clock. This is Jason Kay. Tens of thousands of railway workers will go out on strike again tomorrow after the latest pay talks ended without an agreement. The RMT union accused the Transport Secretary of wrecking the negotiations by not allowing Network Rail to withdraw a letter threatening almost 3,000 redundancies. Grant Shapps said those claims were a total lie. Our business correspondent Ben King is following developments.
It looked like things were a bit more positive this morning. We had a statement from Network Rail saying that the two sides got close to an agreement yesterday. They've been in talks for much of the day, and it looked like, you know, the longer the talks went on, the more optimistic, you know, one could be about what they were talking about. But it seems that the two sides are as far away as ever. This issue of compulsory redundancies remains one that the two sides just cannot find an agreement on.
Taliban officials in Afghanistan believe at least 1,000 people have been killed in an earthquake. Around 2,000 homes near the border with Pakistan have reportedly been destroyed. A survivor of child sexual exploitation in Rotherham has said it's a kick in the teeth that no police officers will be held to account after a report concluded that victims had been failed. The Independent Office for Police Conduct found that crimes weren't properly investigated between 1997 and 2013 because of systemic problems at the South Yorkshire Force. Sammy Woodhouse, who was raped by grooming gangs as a teenager, feels badly let down.
It's disgusting. The fact that all this has happened and not one person will ever be held to account on a professional level. Lives have been ruined. I think they still have a very long way to go.
Well, South Yorkshire Police said the Force of Today was a very different organisation with a specialist team to deal with child sexual exploitation. Health officials are urging people to make sure they're vaccinated against polio after the virus that causes the disease was found in London sewage samples. No cases of polio have actually been detected, though, and experts say the risk is low. Scientists believe the traces are from someone who was immunised abroad with a vaccine that hasn't been used in the UK since 2004. A statue of a man, woman and child standing on suitcases has been unveiled in London to pay tribute to the Windrush generation. The monument at Waterloo Station celebrates the thousands of people who arrived in the UK to help rebuild Britain after the Second World War. The Bishop of Dover, the Reverend Rose Hudson Wilkin, who's on the Windrush Commemoration Committee, said it was important to remember the sacrifices people had made.
We do not forget the painful memories of separation, loss, and rejection experienced by that generation and shared by so many then and now. We actually carry it still in our DNA.
Yeah, the weather dry and clear for large parts of the UK this evening, but it will be cloudy in Northern Ireland and Western Scotland. And that's the BBC News at 6:03.
Jason, thank you very much.
Someone by your side to sing.
Life's a happy song.
when there's someone by your side to sing.
Life's a happy song when there's someone by your side to sing along.
We are by your side till 7 o'clock. Then Joe is here welcoming the one, the only Damon Albarn onto her show. Tonight's NPD, I'm reading it live. And it's the Gibbos, they're in Swindon, having Cajun barbecue, chicken thighs, mozzarella, sun-dried tomato pasta and a herb, leaf, spice, beetroot salad. Finished with a balsamic glaze. Tomorrow, Chiwetel Ejiofor and Naomi Harris talk to Zoe about their new TV series, The Man Who Fell to Earth.